Good morning, good morning. Welcome to Historic Pleasant Green Missionary Baptist Church at 540 West Maxwell Street. We welcome you this morning as we, as a church body, celebrate the birth of Christ. We lift this day our cantata music. We will have our call to worship at this time, followed by scripture and then prayer. Would you join me in our call to worship? God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. God is a spirit, and they that worship must worship him in spirit and in truth. Our scripture this morning will come to us from 2 Samuel, the 7th chapter. 2 Samuel, the 7th chapter. We'll begin at verse 1, concluding with verse 11. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from all the surrounding enemies, the king summoned Nathan the prophet. "Look," David said, "I am living in a beautiful cedar palace, but the ark of God is out there in a tent." Nathan replied to the king, "Go ahead and do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that same night, the Lord said to Nathan, "Go and tell my servant David, this is what the Lord has declared. Are you the one to build a house for me to live in? I have never lived in a house from the day I brought the Israelites out of Egypt until this very day. I have always moved from one place to another with a tent and a tabernacle as my dwelling. Yet no matter where I have gone with the Israelites, I have never once complained to Israel's tribal leaders, the shepherds of my people Israel. I have never asked them, 'Why haven't you built me a beautiful cedar house?' Now go and say to my servant David, 'This is what the Lord of heaven's armies has declared. I took you from tending sheep in the pasture and selected you to be the leader of my people, Israel. I have been with you wherever you have gone, and I have destroyed all your enemies before your eyes. Now I will make your name as famous as anyone who has ever lived on the earth. And I will provide a homeland for my people, Israel, planting them in a secure place where they will never be disturbed. Evil nations won't oppress them as they've done in the past. Starting from the time I appointed judges to rule my people Israel, and I will give you rest from all your enemies. Furthermore, the Lord declares that he will make a house for you, a dynasty of kings." May the Lord bless the readers, hearers, and doers of his holy and divine word. Would you join me now in prayer? Gracious and all-wise God, we come thanking you for this day. Thank you for another day that our eyes have not seen. Thank you, God, for your presence. Thank you, God, for being with us in this our time. We ask, God, now that you will bless this service. Bless this music. Bless this worship. Bless this sermon. Bless all those who are under the sound of my voice that will partake in this special program. We ask now, God, your continued grace and mercy, your truth and your love be with us now and forevermore. Amen. And now, if you will join me in welcoming our own brother, Marion Shockley, as he delivers unto us our cantata music. Each year at this church, I have been here for 30 years, and without fail, we have had a cantata service around Christmas time. And this year, though it will be different, we will still have special music for your enjoyment. So please welcome Brother Marion Shockley and the special music program.
Christmas isn't showy gifts or glittering decorations. It's honoring our Savior Jesus Christ in humble adoration. It's serving those fortunate, meeting their needs before our own. It's making sure at Christmas time that no one is alone, that no one is alone. It's taking what we would have spent on things that no one needs and using it to help someone with service and good deeds. Our Savior showed us how to live with charity, faith, and service. It makes the holidays a joy, more peaceful, and less nervous. So let's remember Christmas is about our Savior's birth. At Christmas, lights burn brighter and friendly hugs get even tighter. The spirit of Christmas fills the air and people seem to really care. Merry hearts are filled with cheer. Families and friends all draw near. The streets around are all filled despite the cold winter chill. Everywhere there's smiling faces, giving and receiving warm embraces. And for a time, sadness disappears. Peace, joy, and hope replaces fear. All because God's love came down and filled the earth all around. So we celebrated Christmas time, our Savior and Lord, holy, divine. We honor Jesus throughout the year, so the Christmas spirit will linger near. For the story of his birth is ours to tell, that Jesus became our Emmanuel.
Well, it's celebration time. I can tell somebody it's celebration time. It's celebration time. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Come on and set the atmosphere for a celebration, and let us exalt his name together. I have a question for you, Pleasant. Will you help me celebrate the Father? Will you help me celebrate the King of Kings? Come on, do me a favor right where you are. Put your hands on it. Clap, clap, clap. Come on, come on. This song simply says, Emmanuel, we worship you. Come on, clap your hands, everybody.
Come, let us adore him.
This is what you say.
Say Emmanuel. Say Emmanuel. Say Emmanuel. Say Emmanuel. Oh, say Emmanuel. Say Emmanuel.
Come on. We worship a good, good Father, a great Father. We worship you.
Oh, 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 oh.
Come on, we're gonna go back on the top.
Come, let us adore you. Oh Lord, kneel down before him. Worship and adore. Oh, 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 Lord, come let us adore him, kneel down before him,
here's your part again. Say Emmanuel.
December night, each home is filled with candlelight. The moon shines brightly in a golden sky. Stars are twinkling way up high. The cool, still air, a glistening frost. Smoking chimneys on white rooftops. The Christmas tree, the mistletoe. Christmas carols, our loved ones at home. Christmas is a time for merriment and cheer. It's also a time to thank God we're here. So when we wake on a bright Christmas morn, remember the reason we celebrate is the day our Savior was born.
Oh, the celebration's just beginning. Come on, clap your hands, everybody. This song says, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Get up and move with me. Put your hands together. Sing it.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy. For he is good.
It's all right to tap your foot.
For he is good.
Oh Lord,
oh Lord.
Say,
oh give thanks to the Lord. Yes sir, yeah. For he is good. Sing, oh give thanks to the Lord. For he is good. Oh Lord. Sing, oh give thanks unto the Lord. For he is good. Yes, he is good.
Going up.
Oh, give thanks.
Yes, sir.
For he is good. Yes, he is good.
Come on, sing it with me.
Unto the Lord. For he is good. Yes, he is good. Sing, oh, give thanks. Unto the Lord. For he is good. Yes, he is good. Sing, oh, give thanks. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord. For he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy. For he is good. Oh Lord. For he is. sing, oh, give thanks. Come on, are you clapping? For he is good. He is good. Sing, oh, give thanks. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord. For he is good. Sing, he is good. For he is worthy. He is good.
I think we got one more time.
Oh, oh Lord, oh, for he is good. He is good. Sing, oh, give thanks.
Come on, y'all should be singing by now.
For he is good. He is good. Sing, oh, give thanks unto. For he is good. Sing, he is good. Sing, oh, give thanks unto the Lord. For he is good, oh, for he is worthy, oh Lord, oh Lord. He is good, for he is worthy, worthy, he is good.
Listen,
I just want to say, you are worthy to be praised. I just want to say, you are worthy to be praised. Say,
yes, sir.
Say, you are worthy to be praised. Oh, Lord, want to say, you are worthy. See, I just want to say, I just want to say, oh Lord, oh Lord, you are.
Come on,
sing. I just want to say, you are, oh, oh, want to say, oh Lord. Say you are worthy, oh Lord.
Come on, worship the Father.
What do we love about Christmas? Does our delight reside in things, or are the feelings in our hearts the real gift Christmas brings? It's seeing those we love and sending Christmas cards too. Appreciating people who bring us joy, special people just like you.
We going to the islands. Come on, get up and move with me. This song says, open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. Come on.
Shining in the light of your glory. we sing, holy, holy, holy.
Come on.
Sing, open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
Come on, sing it with me.
Sing, open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you.
Yeah, come on.
Sing, open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
Yeah.
Open the eyes of my heart, I want to see you. Oh, I want to see you.
Come on, to see you high and lifted up.
High and lifted up, oh Lord, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. To see you high and lifted up, oh, shining in the light of your glory. So pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy.
Sing it again.
To see you high and lifted up, oh, 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 shining in the light of your glory. So pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy.
Come on, lift your hands right there.
Holy, 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 oh Lord, shining in the light of your glory. So pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy.
Sing that with me.
Sing, holy, holy, holy.
Come on, y'all sound good.
Sing, holy, holy, holy. Oh, holy, holy, holy.
Oh, holy night. Just a moment. If you know it, sing it with me.
Oh, holy night, the stars uprightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Oh. Long lay the world in sin and ever pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Oh, what
on, sing it.
All night, divine, oh Lord, oh, all night, all night divine.
Now come on, lift your hands right there. Worship him for a moment. Our Savior divine.
Huddle near. May family gather together without heartache or tear. There is a star shining in the night sky, just there. It is for you to wish upon, to keep you safe from care. May everything you need be yours to have and proclaim as you're due. Just close your eyes and ask it in his precious name. Merry Christmas to you, friend. Let your season be a blessed one, filled with love and cheer and more. Smile, laugh, and enjoy the bun.
All right, here's a song that everybody knows.
Hallelujah, salvation and glory, oh Lord, honor and power unto the Lord our God.
Come on, brother.
For the Lord our God is mighty. Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent. The Lord our God, He is wonderful.
Come on, sing it again.
Hallelujah, salvation and glory. Oh Lord, honor and power unto the Lord our God.
That's it.
For the Lord our God is mighty. Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent. The Lord our God, He is wonderful.
Where my altos at? This your part.
All praises be to the King of Kings and the Lord our God. He is wonderful. All praises be to the King of Kings and the Lord our God. He is wonderful.
Where my sopranos at?
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. He is wonderful.
Come on.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. He is wonderful.
Come on, tenors.
Hallelujah, salvation and glory, honor and power, He is wonderful.
Come on, tenor, sing it again.
Hallelujah, salvation and glory, and power, He is wonderful. Hallelujah, salvation and glory. Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent. The Lord our God, He is wonderful. Say, He is wonderful.
Sing that.
Say, He is wonderful.
Come on, let me hear you. Last time.
Say, He is wonderful.
Thank you, Brother Marion Shockley, for that wonderful music this day. I hope you all have enjoyed those pleasant sounds and those glorious tributes to our God in the highest. And now it is time for our sermon. If you have your Bibles, would you turn with me to the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verse 6 and 7. I will read from the New Living Translation. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. The government will rest on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His government and its peace will never end. He will rule with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor David for all eternity. The passionate commitment of the Lord of Heaven's armies will make this happen. May the Lord bless those readers, hearers, and doers of his holy word. God, is again that we come to ask your preaching power. We ask, God, that this message might reach the ears of those whom you have intended it for, that they might hear and heed the message therein. Thank you again for your presence. Thank you again for your love, for your grace and your mercy. In Jesus' name, amen. This joy. This joy. Thank you again, Brother Shockley, for the special music on this day. As I said before, we always have such lovely music in this place, and we thank you for sharing. This joy. What is it about this time of the year that makes people so happy? What makes folks want to sing carols and wrap presents, address cards, or adorn dwellings with tinsel and lights? What is it about this season? What is it about this pending end to the year Is it that we look forward to having another chance to get things right? Is it that we have a chance to clear the slate and begin anew? What is it about this time of the year? Ordinarily in this city, we are inundated with large crowds in the mall and shopping venues and heavy traffic on the streets. But these are not ordinary times. If COVID-19 were a book, I can assure you the sadness and sorrow would be two of its major divisions. What is it about this time? But, there is still this sense of joy that I have. I was asked not long ago about how I am able to continue doing what it is that I do as a chaplain in the hospital. What keeps me going? What sustains me? What helps me to be present with the people whom God has directed me to? And my response was very simple. It is that I believe that God is still sovereign. I believe that God still sits on the throne and that he is in control and that this is my work and that he is present in it. So that's how I am able to continue going on. That is how I can explain and express the fact that I can still have joy even in the times of sorrow and sadness. I can still have joy even when there is a pandemic going on. I can still have joy when I have to be with people who are experiencing loss and sorrow, because God is still in control. There is this joy that I have. Here we are celebrating this third Sunday of December with our annual Christmas cantata. However, in keeping with everything else, the cantata will be experienced differently this year. Gone is the opportunity to revel in the beauty of this sanctuary, so eloquently decorated by Sister Gay. Absent is the delivery of Christmas cards by Reverend Emerson and his crew. Lost is the chance for a family photo from Brother Jackson. We will not fellowship together in the reception that always follows the program. There will be no fruit, no baskets, no books. But there is still joy. There is still music, because there is still cause for celebration. COVID may have altered much of what we like to do around this time, but there is still joy. Shirley Caesar had a popular song that reminds us of this very thought. This joy that I have, the world didn't give to me. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me, and the world can't take it away. This joy that I have. So as we begin turning our eyes towards Christmas morning, let us be mindful of the true reason for this season. It is the incarnation of God's love in the birth of God's Son, Jesus. This is the reason for the season. The central idea of the Christmas season is remembering the birth of Jesus and the light he brought into this world. This is the greatest of gifts. This gift was for you and for me, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. It isn't about who is being naughty or nice, but God showed his great love for us by sending Christ to die for us while we were still sinners. This joy that I have. It's not about an old man who lives at the North Pole and makes annual visits at this time of the year. No, it's about Jesus. It's about the babe born in Bethlehem, wrapped in swaddling clothes and laid in a manger. Jesus, the one who would grow in the appearance and likeness of men. Jesus, the one who would one day humble himself and become obedient even to the death, the death of the cross. It's about Jesus, the one whom God the Father has highly exalted and given the name which is above every name, the name that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. That name is Jesus. That's the reason for this season. That's the reason that I have joy. That's the reason that I can continue on. The prophet Isaiah delivered his timeless message of hope and joy to the people living in a world of darkness and despair. Not only was a child born and a son given to us, but his special character as the Messiah was revealed. He is a wonderful counselor. He is the mighty God. He is the everlasting Father. He is the Prince of Peace. He is the reason for the season. When the angel of the Lord appeared before the shepherds who were guarding their flocks of sheep on that very first night, his radiance surrounded them and they were terrified. But the angel reassured them, "I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David." A little further down in that story, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, and they began praising God with these words, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased. This joy that I have, the world can't take it away. This joy that I have has been secured because God gave his son. And in giving his son took a cross. His son was put on that Roman cross and he died. He died on that cross and he was put in a borrowed tomb. It was borrowed because he had no plans to stay there long. He got up on that third day. He got up on that first morning, and he declared, "All power is in his hands. That is the reason I have this joy." And as a way of invitation, on this invitation today, I'd like to share with you an abridged version of an illustration I was reading while preparing this message. And it goes a little like this. Some years ago, a Bible teacher was greeted by a stranger who was in need of help understanding the word. The teacher was in a hurry as he was about to board a train when the stranger approached him. So the teacher left the stranger with a Bible and the following instructions. "Take this Bible and go to the nearest lamppost. Turn to Isaiah 53:6. Stoop down low and go in at the first all. Then stand up straight and come out at the last all." Isaiah 53:6 reads, "All us like sheep have strayed away. We have left God's path to follow our own. Yet the Lord laid on him the sins of us all." The stranger realized with the first all that he must admit he'd gone astray, that he turned away from God. Then he contemplated the second all and realized he didn't have to carry that load of guilt anymore. If you are here, if you are listening and you don't know Jesus in the pardon of your sin, go in at that first all. Realize that you are a sinner in need of salvation. Realize that you have walked away. And then when you get there, stand up and come out at that second all and realize that God has put all of that burden on his only begotten son. That's not our weight to carry. Jesus paid that price. You don't have to carry that load of guilt anymore. God has made a way. God has given. That's the reason for this joy.
Here's a song that everybody knows. Sing it with me. Come on, how many know we serve a great God? Come on, who sits high and looks low. Hallelujah, sing it with me.
How great is our God? Sing with me. How great is our God? All will see how great is our God. Oh, how great. great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. All will see how great is our God. Oh Lord, oh Lord, you're the name above all names, and you are worthy of all praise. And our hearts will sing how great is our God. Oh Lord, oh Lord, you're the name above all names.
Sing it with me.
You are worthy of all praise, and our hearts will sing how great is our God. Oh Lord, how great is our God.
Come on, lift it up.
Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, see how great is our God. Oh, how great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, see how great is our God. How great is our God.
Come on, sing it.
Sing with me, how great. Yeah. Oh, sing how great. How great is our God.
Receive now the benediction. Grace, mercy, truth, rest, rule, and abide, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let the church say amen.